Hello dear students, today we are going to see the practical from the Medicinal Chemistry 3, that is third year B Pharmacy semester 6. The aim of our today's practical is to draw chemical structure and reaction schemes using ChemSketch software. Myself Professor Deepali Kadam from KKVA College of Pharmacy Nasik, Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry. The chemical structure represents a range of target from very simple molecule, for example diatomic hydrogen, to a very complex one such as protein. Therefore, a computer program sought since the beginning for creating and modifying representations of chemical structures and the reactions. Currently, several computer programs including standalone programs such as ACD ChemSketch, ArgusLab BKChem, next Java applets, Acrylic, JDraw, JChem Paint, JME Molecule Editor, next JavaScript Embedded Editors, Angular DrawChem, Sketchers, MarvinJS, MolaInspiration, WebME Molecule Editor, then some online editors like MolEdit, Marvin, PubChem Online, and some mobile editors apps like ChemDoodle Mobile. These softwares are available for drawing the chemical structures and the reactions. The computer program Cambridge Soft's ChemDraw is a user-friendly and the industry leader in chemical and reaction drawing. In addition, it analyzes the properties and provides sophisticated search and the information functions. ChemDraw is operated by a combination of tools and commands that can be selected from a tools palette, usually for a number of frequently used structural components, for example benzene, imidazole, etc., and the menus respectively. The cost of entry-level commercial ChemDraw Prime 16 is about 9.56 lakh with perpetual license, and its academic price is about 0.10 lakhs with 1 year license. The another one software is ChemSketch, which is a comprehensive structure editor with a variety of tools and functionality that ease the communication of scientific and the chemical information, which is used to draw molecular structure, which generate the structure or copy or paste from the ChemDraw. Easily and quickly we can include the known molecules from ChemSketch. You can insert a pre-drawn template of amino acid, aromatic, steroids, sugar, and the many more. Search the dictionary of more than 170,000 systematic, trivial, and the trade names for the chemicals, or you can say the drawn structures. Easily drawn reactions and the complex chemical schemes that including biotransformation maps can also be done with the help of ChemSketch. You can use a graphical template and the tools to communicate chemistry and the chemical biology concept, for example chemical bond type, Lewis structures, molecular orbitals, Newman projections, peptide sequence, and the more. You can import or export the structure file in a variety of standard file formats. You can draw the complex scheme such as biotransformation maps with very ease. You can draw organic molecules, organometallics, biomolecules, polymers, Lewis structures, 2D and the 3D structures representation, and the more. You can calculate the quantities for the chemical reaction with automatically calculated chemical formula, molecular weight, etc. Dear students, now we will see a demonstration of the drawing the structure and the chemical reaction with the help of ChemSketch software. Students, before starting the direct demonstration on ChemSketch software, let us see how to download ChemSketch software. So, first of all, you have to use your Google as a search engine. Just type ChemSketch software free download. After that, you will see a page like this. Just click here, fill your proper information, accept the terms and conditions, and download the software. As I have already downloaded this software, so I am skipping this step. Student, when you are opening your software, you will get the window like this. Just click on OK and close this window. Okay. These are the dialog box to give you the instructions regarding how to use the ChemSketch software. Okay. So this will be your total window. It will be occur on your PC or you can say the laptop when you are installing this on your personal system. So you can see as a in general mode, you can see over here a file menu where you can open a new file, you can open a previous file, even you can close the file, you can save it, save as. Okay. The second tab is your edit tab, where you can undo or redo the command whatever you are applied over here. Then you can cut the text selected, copy the text, even you can paste. Okay. Then next is pages. Here you can insert a new page, new, even you can delete this, you can rename the page, even you can change the color. Let us see how to color change. Now you can see this background is white color, so you can change a background like this. Okay, see, you can see over here your background is changed. So again I am changing this to the white. Okay, then next is tools. Here is you can get the structure properties, and you even you can generate a stereo description of your structure. You can generate a structure from the Smiles notification. Then you can transform the structure in different form. Then next is template. Then next is option. Here you can see the grids also. If you click over here, you can get a grids. Okay. Again, I am showing. This is the plain page. Then show palettes is there. Then set the structure drawing size, that is the normal. There are the different journals and they require the different formats for the structures also. So on that basis also, you can give the command to your structures and you can draw the different structure. Like you can say the European Journal of Organic Chemistry, European Journal of Inorganic Chemistry is there, Carbohydrate Research is there. Likewise, there are the different styles is given for the structures. Then this is the document, then add-on, then ECD lab is there, and any help you want, then again there is possible. After that, here you can see, just a minute, here you can see a periodic table of elements. Okay, now this is the classic periodic table where it has given a general classification of the periodic table, like first S block, S block, P block, D block and the F block. You can see the colors over here, and likewise that elements are classified. Then next is your aggregation state. Here they have given like this light blue color. These gas elements are present in gaseous state, then some elements are present in liquid state. And some are these dark blue, these are present in, you can say, the solid state. Okay, then here you can choose metals and non-metals also. This yellow colored, yellow highlighted element, these are the non-metals, and remaining all are the metals also. Even you can see the radioactivity of elements. Whatever the elements, these are shown with the dark green color. These are the radioactive elements. Okay. And last one is your none. Okay. So I am using a classic type of periodic table. Okay, this is about the periodic table. Next, this left side bar, it is here you can see the carbon, hydrogen. You can just put over here carbon, you will get the carbon. Okay, I am just showing you. If you are putting click on the hydrogen, you can get hydrogen over here. Okay, similarly nitrogen, similarly oxygen, then fluorine, sodium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, potassium. Okay, along with this you can include text also over here, some R1, R2, R3, R4, like substitution also you can give. This about this left side taskbar, just I am deleting all this. Okay, the next you can see this right hand side taskbar. Okay, so here is table of radical. Here you can draw the number of chains. Okay, and carbon 3, carbon 4, carbon 5, isopropyl, secondary butyl, tertiary butyl, like this. Even you can draw some cycles also, 3 carbon cycles, 4, 5, 6 carbon, even double bonded, benzene ring, carbon 7, carbon 8. Then here are the some amino acids also there. Okay, alanine, glycine, phenylalanine, arginine, histidine, proline, okay, aspargine. The short forms are given over here, glutamine, glutamic acid, ornithine, valine, okay. Then some protecting groups are also there. You can say the diacyl, trifluoroacetyl, tosyl, okay. Some miscellaneous groups like NO2, okay, isocyanato, acetoxy, sulfo, phosphono, then isothiocyanato, nitroso, cyanato, okay. Along with this, some other groups are there, vinyl, allyl, ethanol, cyano group, then trityl, you can say this, so you are a trichloromethyl, trifluoromethyl, like this, different groups, chains, cycles, group, miscellaneous groups, amino acids, protecting groups are available over here. Then you can drag a chain directly, you can drop the benzene, okay, cyclohexane, cyclopentane, tertiary butyl, acetyl group, this acid group, this nitro group, phosphono group, this one is your sulfo group. Like this you can draw from here. Okay, so here we have completed the just information about our different, one more function is there, you can select this all and directly you can delete. Okay, let us think about this drawing function and the structure function. Okay, one by one we will see over here. Students, let us see this second tool, that is the drawing tool. Okay, so in this drawing tool you can see, you can draw a line C. Okay, then you can draw a curve line also to show the various reaction. Then you can draw the different arrows also. Okay, even you can make a curve arrows from that also. Okay, then you can draw a rectangle. Even you can draw the circle also from there. Then you can insert image also here. You can insert a text also. Then you can give the brackets to the any reaction intermediate. Then You can zoom any spectra is there if available. Along with this, if you have given the name to any structure, then just I'm showing you. Okay, if you have given the name to the structure, okay, so for example, what you have to do, okay, you have to click over here, edit text. Okay, here you have to give the, you will get a box, then you have to write down the name of the drug. For example, I have written the paracetamol. As I have told you, there are the some journals and they require the structures according to their standard guidelines. So here you can give them a different font size, okay, different font, you can increase or decrease the font. Even you can make a bold, italic, you can underline that structure. Okay. If you have to give the some superscript, for example, I have written over here H2SO4. Okay. Now, first of all, I am making it a normal instead of making bold. Okay. Okay. So, like the here that it should be two, should be a subscript. So it should be like this. Okay. Here it is not showing properly. Let us have the different font. Okay. Okay. This H2SO4. Okay. Like here, you can give. Actually, it is in a subscript or superscript. Okay, that's why. Now, this is in normal writing. So, H2 and this 4 will become like this. Okay. So, you can use this template. Again, you can give the left alignment, central alignment, right alignment, justify. Okay. Then, next point is, I'm just clearing all this. Then you can prepare a new document also over here. Okay. See. Then multiple new pages also there you can prepare. You can delete a page. You can open a file. Okay. You can save a file just clicking on here. You can print these. You can save these files to the PDF format also. These are undo and reduce button, you know. For deleting any wrong structure, you can use this command. Then you can copy the structure, you can paste the structure, you can zoom in and zoom out the structure, even you can change the percentage of the your page. Okay, see, I am changing the percentage. Then these are some full page, page width options, fit all. Next is important, this open template window. Okay, so this is very important. Here is also structures. So first of all, you can get a number of groups here. Okay, different carbon groups, then different carbohydrate structure you can draw, different RNA, DNA and RNA structures are basic structures are here, then different lab kits are available there. You, if you want to draw some reactions, you want to show the beaker, flask, RBF, okay, three naked RBF, stopper, you can use this, even your thermometer, you can say the, see the dropping funnels, separating funnels are there, okay. You can use this mortar, pestle, different lab kit is there. Next important, you can even show the Newman's projection formulas also. Okay, see eclipse formula, staggered formula with the rotations and that graph. Then you can give the different diagrams for that structures. Then even you can draw the orbitals also, like this p orbital, sp orbital, hybridization you can explain on this basis. Then some phosphorus compounds also you can draw over here. Then some steroids molecule, gonane, estrane, androstan, then choline, pregnen, These also you can draw from here. Then some sugar molecule also you can take from over here. Then terpenes, then vitamins also. Okay. Now this is for vitamin A to A and B. Even your C, D vitamins are also available here. Then vitamin E is there, K, U, vitamin M, K3. Okay. Then let us see different amino acids are there structures. Alanine, arginine, aspartic acid, histidine, glycine. Then L-alanine is there, L-aspartate is there, L-aspartic acid is there, L-histidine is there. Then radicals are also available there. Alpha-aspartyl, histidyl, glycyl, glutaminyl. Then these other radicals like cysteinyl and alanyl. Okay. Even you can see the different arrows for required for our reactions. Okay, if any reaction is that is two component comes, you if you have drawn any component over here and second one is here, so you can use this arrow like this. These types of arrows also you can draw. These colorful arrows are also available over there. Then these carbon chains are also available. Okay, 3 carbon propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane. Okay, saturateds are there. These are some unsaturated 8 carbon, 9 carbon. These are also available. Then these are different HPLC pumping systems are also given over here. Means you can use different lab kits also over here. Even Lewis structures to show the lone pair of electrons, these are also available. Okay. Then orbitals already we have seen. Some of these polycyclic, bridged polycyclic compounds, tetrahedron, cubane, homocubane, dihomocubane. Okay. Then you can see over here. These fenestrans are also available there. These propellants also available there. Okay. So next is you can say reaction symbols. These are also available. Steroid molecule already we have seen. Colistin, ergostin. Okay. These are also another steroids molecules. Vitamin structure already we have seen. This lab kit, you can see the distillation apparatus is also there. Different lab kits are available. We have just seen the one only. This separation apparatus are available, distillation apparatus, reaction apparatus are also available. Then this different thermometer, distillation assembly, dropping funnels, then reaction apparatus. Then different flasks are available. RBF, okay. This is 3 naked flasks. This is different 3 naked flasks. This is 4 naked flasks. This is 2 naked angled round bottom flasks. 2 naked vertical round bottom flasks. Different round flat bottom flasks. Okay. Round bottom flasks with the septum inlet. Then these different stoppers are there. These are rubber stoppers. Then different adapters, condensers. You can see the Grams, West, Allihan's, Liebig, then rotary evaporator trap. Okay, these are different traps available. These are reducing adapters are available. Buchner funnels are available. Means with the help of this ChemSketch software, you cannot only draw the chemical reaction, but you can represent this reaction with the help of different diagrammatic view also. Okay, this is three-way adapter. Then some analyticals also, means some titrations also you can show. Funnel is there. This is powder funnel. This is your you can say the conical flask or Erlenmeyer flask are there. These are different volumetric flask are there. This is support stand, burette holder. This is burette. Okay, these also you can show. And lastly, your burners, beakers, okay, crucibles. Okay, see this tripod stand, Merkur Bunsen burner. Okay, this clamp, this beaker, thermometer. These also you can show. There are various short, but important things available in this. Okay, some labels. Okay, you have to show these labels. Some radioactive labels, the elements are there. How you will show? With the help of this symbol. Then oxidizer, organic peroxide, this flammable gas or liquid, this dangerous. You can show with the help of different signs like this. This flammable solids, corrosives, hazard, irritants, biohazards, these poisons. Okay, you can show with the help of these different symbols. This crown ethers also you can show. 113 crown 4. Okay, 14 crown 4. These different crown ethers also you can use for your different reactions. These chains already we have seen. Then this aromatic ring like benzene, naphthalene. Then you can say you know very well, biphenylene, anthracene, okay, naphthacene. These are the basic rings which are you require during your practice, okay, during your study. You can show with the help of these different tools. These are different saturated rings, okay. Then these are again calyx ring, cyclophens, these are cyclosines, different helicanes. Okay, so different tools are available in this open template window. Okay, then you can even search for the different structure also. You can even generate a name for the structure also with the help of PubChem search. You can search your structure on PubChem. Then E molecule, chem spider, okay. Then enumerate the marks of structure. You can even stereoisomers generate. You can do this. You can even find out the log P value, okay. Along with this, you will get whatever the structure. When we will see the structures in detail, you will get details regarding that structure here, like molecular weight, molecular formula of that structure. Okay. Student, let us start with the drawing of the chemical structure by using ChemSketch software. Okay. Basically, we will start with some basic structure. Okay. So, if we want to draw the structure of methane. Okay. So, it is simply CH4. Okay. Then we will proceed for the further structure. If we want to draw ethane, okay, there are two options. Okay, first of all, you draw the CH4 and then again draw, this is will be your ethane. Okay, one more thing you can do, you can draw the chains also. Okay, so this is carbon 2 chain. Okay, if you we want to draw the structure of propane, 1, 2, 3 carbon. Okay, so it is propane. Then if you want to draw the structure for butane, then it is 4 carbon chain, that is the butane. Similarly, you can draw the structure for pentane, then hexane. Okay, so you can use from this that chain also, and you can draw the chain like structure also. Okay, now we will proceed for the next. If you want to draw some aromatic structure, then you have to take up this benzene. okay. And if you want to draw the toluene, then simply you have to take a CH3, and this is CH3, this is benzene, okay. Next, if we want to draw the benzoic acid, okay, so this is benzene, then we have to draw this CH3, okay. We want here double bond, okay. So for a double bond, just go that with cursor over that bond and click, it will be double bond, okay. Now we have to change this with the oxygen, okay, double bond O. So it is double bond O, and this will be your OH. So this is OH, okay. If you want to clean this structure, you have to just select this, and here is the arrow that is showing clean structure, okay. So clean, okay. So this will be your benzoic acid. Now you have to give the naming to the structure, okay. So just write down over here benzoic acid, okay. So this will be our benzoic acid, okay. The next is, if you want to draw the structure for some, we will start with the some drug molecule. Let us see first the structure for the paracetamol, okay. So for structure for paracetamol, we have to go into the structure mode, then take a benzene ring. So this is your benzene, okay. Then next we want a NH, okay. So here I have click on nitrogen. Now this is NH2, okay. Then next we want carbon, okay. So this is carbon. Next we want oxygen. So this will be your oxygen. Again, here is the double bond, and here is OH, okay. And here again we want OH. So this will be the structure for paracetamol, okay. Now I am selecting this structure and just click on the clean structure, okay. So this will be proper structure, okay. You can give the name to this structure, okay. Click over here, okay. Again you can change the font size, font also, okay. I am keeping the font 10 and the Arial, okay. If you want to move that structure, okay, or this naming, just click on a structure and just move over here, okay. You can reduce the size also, okay. So this will be your paracetamol. Similarly, you can draw the structure, for example, it is the acetic acid, okay. So acetic acid is CH3 C double bond O OH, okay. So we will take first carbon, then the second CA, okay. Now we have to take next OH. So here is OH, and here is your again OH, and this will be your double bond, okay. Now this structure is not looks good, so you have to select this structure and the clean structure, okay. Again you can resize it also, so it will become a proper structure, okay. CH3 C double bond O OH, this is your acetic acid. Again we will give the name acetic acid, okay. Again you can reduce the font size, even you can reduce change the font also. Okay, if I want a Times New Roman, then I will give that font also, okay. Likewise, you can draw a number of structure. Next structure we will draw, for example, acetic anhydride, okay. So we have to take this structure, okay. Two molecules of acetic acid condense and there is a formation of acetic anhydride. Okay, now I want this structure, so I will not draw it again. I make it simply copy, control C, or you can see, you can copy from here also. Okay, and paste, control V. You can just drag the mouse and go on a proper side. Okay, so next I want, okay, this carbon, again this carbon and this molecule will double bond here, and here will it will be oxygen. So this will be the acetic anhydride. Now I have to clean that structure. Okay, so just select this, and here you can see this arrow, there is the clean structure. So this structure will become good. Again, just okay. Let us see the nomenclature for this structure. I have selected this structure. Go over here. Here is the one tab. You can see the generate name for the structure. Okay, click on that and it will give a acetic anhydride. Okay, it will directly generate also, no need to type also. Okay, so this is the drawing of some basic structure. For example, other structure like, let us see the next example, any aldehyde we will draw. See, 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3 carbon and 4 carbon. Okay, and this is double bond. I want to make this as an O. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. It is butanol. Okay. Let us check for the IUPAC nomenclature for the same. Okay. Or the generate the name for the structure. So it is, it will be the butan 2-one. You can see, you can give the number 1, 2, 3, 4. According to the IUPAC nomenclature, you have to give the minimum possible number to the functional group. Okay, so functional group is C double bond O, and it is a, you can say here it is a ketone, it is not your aldehyde. Okay, it is a ketone, R C double bond O R dash. If here is H, then it will be your aldehyde. Okay, next example we will see about the this aldehyde also. So according to IUPAC, this position will be 1, this is 2. So that's why it is 2-one, and it is having 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. That's why it is a butan 2-one. Okay. Let us see the carbon chain for the 6 carbon. Okay. Instead of this, okay, it is the hydrogen. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon, and this is a hydrogen. And here I want to make a double bond. Okay, so at the C1, this is double bond and this is the O. Okay, just a minute. Here I want to make O. Okay, now I want the name for this structure. So first of all, select this structure and click here, generate name for structure. Okay, it will be your hexanol. Why it is a hexanol? First of all, it is the aldehyde, that's why it is a AL, hexanol, AL. Okay, and here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 carbon, that's why it is, it will become hexanol. Similarly, you can draw the structure for ether also. Okay, let us see. Suppose this is 1 carbon, this is 2, this is 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now I want to replace this carbon with oxygen. So I will replace this with oxygen. Again, I will select this structure. Okay, and next, generate the name for structure. So it is your ethoxyethane. Okay, so we will clean also this structure. Okay, so it will have the proper shape. Okay, so you can see it is the ethoxyethane. So with the help of these different atoms present on over here, carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, sodium, silicon, phosphorus and all, and with the help of these different rings also, and you can see over here, here are the different chains are also given. With the help of these also, you can draw the different structure, different medicinal compound also. You can draw even the your different amino acids also. Okay, so this is the basics for your drawing of the structure. Okay, if we want to draw the nitrobenzene, just take a last example. Suppose this is a benzene and we want to introduce a nitro group. Here you can see this is a nitro group. So I just click on the NO2 and give this. Okay, and let us generate the name for this structure. Okay, you can see we have to click on the generate name for the structure. This will be your nitrobenzene. Okay, so we have studied just how to draw the different chain structure. One more point you have to remember, if you we want to convert this ethane into ethene. Okay, so just click on this, just a minute, structure, this is the carbon. Okay, this is ethene, and even you can draw the ethyne also. Okay, see, you can make a alkynes also. Okay, see, these are the different structure, and you can create a name for this structure also. Let us see the nomenclature for this structure. Prop1-ene. Okay, also we will see the nomenclature for the this structure also. This will be but2-ene. Okay, yne. So this is your alkyne and this is your alkene. So these are the basic structure. Then we have drawn the toluene, benzoic acid, paracetamol, then acetic acid, acetic anhydride, then ketone structure, then aldehyde structure, then ether structure, and some nitro compounds also. Students, next part we have to study, that is to draw some chemical reaction using the ChemSketch software. Okay, in this we will going to see the example of synthesis of paracetamol. So the reaction involved in synthesis of paracetamol is when 4-aminophenol reacts with the acetic anhydride in presence of NaOH, there is the formation of acetaminophen and the acetic acid. Now we have to learn how to draw these reactions. Okay, so I am just giving you the one view how you will see the reaction when you will draw it on a chem sketch. So this will be the reaction looks like. Okay, so student, let us start the drawing of reaction. First of all, we want to draw the 4-aminophenol. So basically we will require the benzene ring. Okay, so phenol, so we will require the OH over here. Okay, and the heat disposition will be 4-amino, so we will require the nitrogen. So this will be the 4-amino phenol. Okay, then we want to draw the plus sign. Okay, so my reaction is what? 4-aminophenol plus acetic anhydride. So this is the plus sign. So I am putting this plus sign over here. Then I want to draw the acetic acid. Okay, so this is the CH3, C double bond O, then this will be the oxygen. Okay, again here is CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Okay, here I want oxygen, so this is the oxygen. Here I want to draw the double bond O. Okay, just move the cursor on that bond and click once, it will become a double bond. Similarly over here, okay, this will be the acetic anhydride. Next, I want to draw the arrow. Okay, so this is the reaction arrow. You just click on it and draw with the help of mouse. Okay, this will be the arrow. On the arrow, I have to write down the NaOH. Okay, so I will click on draw, then this edit text, and write down over here. Okay, after that, lastly we will arrange all the reaction content properly. So this is NaOH. Okay, again we have to move towards the structure mode. Before that, just okay, we will move this NaOH like this. So it will be the on the arrow. Okay, this is NaOH. Next, we have to draw the acetoamino pen, that is the paracetamol. Okay, so for that we will require first a benzene ring. Okay, next we will require the OH at this position. So this will be the OH. Next, we have to add nitrogen at here, then carbon next to the nitrogen, and again it is a CH3. And here we have to add a carbonyl functional group. So I am making it as a double bond, then I will convert it into oxygen. Okay, so this is our paracetamol. Next, we have to add, so that's why along with this paracetamol there is the formation of acetic acid also. So this is the plus sign, so I have click on this reaction plus, so this is the plus sign. Now I have to draw the structure for the acetic acid. So we will take a carbon, this is CH3, again C double bond O we have to make, and this is OH. Okay, so make here double one more bond. Now I have to change this into a OH double bond O, and this is OH, so it will become your acetic acid. Okay, now there is the one option, you can select all over reaction and then clean the structure, or you can simply clean the structure one by one. Okay, so I will show you how to clean the structure one by one. Select this structure. Okay, select this structure, then click on the clean structure. Okay, again you can resize it also, so it will become like this. You can move this plus sign also, then clean the next structure of the acetic acid. Okay, you can also resize this structure. This will be your acetic acid. Okay, then you can move this arrow also. Similarly, move this NaOH. Okay, one more thing, when you are writing this NaOH, okay, you can decrease the size of font size. You can say the NaOH, that will be the smaller, so it will be, we will keep 9. Okay, again you can move the this box and keep it on a proper side. Okay, you can see now. Next is our structure of acetoamino pen. Okay, so again select this structure, clean the structure, and move the structure accordingly. And again you can resize it also. Just a minute. You can resize this also. Okay, next is keep this plus sign over here. then select this acetic acid structure, clean it and resize also, and you can move it also. So it looks very good. Okay, now you can see this is the proper reaction. Now we will generate the name for the structure. Okay, select that structure, click on this is your para amino, 4 amino phenol or para amino phenol you can say. Next, select this acetic acid and click on generate the name. So it is acetic anhydride. We will move the position of this name also, and we will resize also. Then next is this structure, just select it. Okay, so it is your N4 hydroxyphenyl acetamide, and last one, this is your last structure. Okay, generate the name for that, that is your acetic acid. Let us okay, you can change the font size from here, keep it 10. Okay, so it will be like, looks like this. Okay, again you have to decrease the font size, apply. Okay, same for others also, same for this also. Okay, so this is our complete reaction, synthesis of paracetamol from the 4 amino phenol and the acetic anhydride. So students, I hope you have understood this practical very clearly. In this practical, we have studied the drawing of the structure. Basically, we have started with the detailed tabs, detailed menus available in the ChemSketch software. And then we have started with the drawing of some basic structures. Then up to the reaction we have drawn. Okay. Thank you, students.